out, check it out.
Okay, hey, put this on.
I'm wasting time here, boys.
Put some water in.
Yeah, it's too hot out.
You gotta hydrate, man.
Powering gels. Oh,
got some gels here.
You need sugar?
Getting better?
Oh, yeah. Keep massaging that.
Keep that. Have some more.
Thanks, boys.
Have some more.
What did I say
before? There you go.
Exercise-associated muscle cramps.
Man, Shane, that was pretty tough out there. We're just not getting the results we've been looking for in the last little while. What do you think's going on?
I don't know. During the end of the race, you know, like when I'm slowing down near the end and I'm trying to push myself and I just get these painful contractions in my calves and it's debilitating. I can't keep running. I got to sit down and it seems to go away after a couple minutes, but it's taking time off my performance.
Okay, that sounds like a classic case of exercise-associated muscle cramps, which is defined as painful, spastic, involuntary contractions of a skeletal muscle results in painful outcomes like you just had.
It's painful, yeah. That's what it sounds like. You can't run?
Yeah, sounds, that's the diagnosis, maybe. I don't know, these power gels, I don't know, these got things you got me on, it's bananas. Just aren't working and they keep happening, so I don't know what to do, guys. Like, I keep paying this money to help me train and it's just not working.
So Vic, do you have any theories about why Shane might be experiencing exercise associated muscle cramps?
Yeah, well, I was reading up on the BJSM and one of the main causes is dehydration. So basically you're getting a lack of insufficient fluids in your body while you're exercising, and with the combination of high sweat volume, this contributes to your contractions. This will cause a decrease in your plasma volume, which will increase plasma osmolarity. Due to this loss of interstitial fluid, it will cause several mechanisms within motor neurons, which will cause these muscle contractions. As you're competing in your event, you become progressively more dehydrated because you're getting a lack of fluids in your body. And the extracellular fluid compartment becomes contracted. Do you understand what I'm saying? And this will contribute to your likelihood of getting cramps. But cramping is a multifactorial problem because dehydration coupled with muscle fatigue and electrolyte imbalance will cause these cramps. So you have to believe me, son. We're doing everything we can to get you to Rio.
Oh yeah, man. I understand that. Sounds pretty scientific, but you know, I've been working on it for a while and you know, it's still a cause. How about you, trainer, too?
Well, Shane, the theory I'm familiar with when it comes to exercise-associated muscle cramps is the electrolyte depletion theory, which I read about in a few different studies. Now, basically, this theory explains that your muscles are cramping due to a loss, through sweating, of concentration of electrolytes, things like sodium, potassium, chloride, and calcium, which all help your muscles contract. Part of the theory is that cramps occur more often in heat due to increased sweating in hot environments. The mechanism is that when you sweat, you get an increased plasma osmolarity in your muscles caused by loss of electrolytes in your sweat. This results in fluid moving from the axon terminals susceptible to hyperexcitability by mechanical deformation. This causes the nerve terminals to be at a greater risk of discharging, resulting in localized muscle cramping.
So what do you think I should be doing to fix this?
Well, Shane, we have you on a periodized program with good prehabilitation routine, as well as a dynamic warm-up and stretching before your races. We also have you pre-hydrating, as well as getting fluids in during the race, along with electrolyte substances like power gel, to try and replenish your electrolytes while you're going so these things don't happen. So I really don't understand why you're still getting cramps out there.
You know what, guys, I'm sick of this, you know, electrolyte hydration science bullshit, and I'm sick of these power gel. I'm sick of this. Compression
we can,
suit.
We
like,
can
what is
on
this,
it.
Man? Like, I'm out of here. I'm gonna go find some new trainers.
I'll use our chance for the Olympics.
Hi, this is Shane C. Jones. I just qualified for Rio and I'm having some real troubles with my trainer. I was hoping that Jimmy from Next Level could help me out. I'm having real troubles getting through these cramp issues and yeah, I was wondering what you could do for me.
Hey, Mr. Jones. Looking forward to possibly working with you. Sounds like they're using the dehydration and electrolyte depletion theory. Your trainers are focusing on heat cramps rather than exercise-induced muscle cramps. Would you like to come in and discuss this further?
Awesome, that sounds great, Jimmy. I'll see you Thursday.
You guys, see Jones?
How's it going?
Glad
to
you guys can meet with me. You know what, my old trainers, they're more focused on these electrolyte imbalances and hydration and keeping my thermoregulation intact, and I was still getting cramps. And I heard about you too, and you guys got some more research for me.
Well, look at the treatment of muscle cramps. We can see that it fails to support the dehydration electrolyte imbalance. To explain this, try to look at the main reason for muscle cramps. Like, if it was dehydration, then wouldn't the obvious treatment be as simple as just fluid replacement?
This is not the case. It's found in Kevin Miller's lit review on like muscle cramps that even with proper ingestion of carbohydrates and electrolytes to match those lost via sweat, muscle cramps were still found to occur in athletes. Further dehydration and fluid loss doesn't make sense, as you ingest similar amounts of fluid during exercise when compared to that of your fellow athletes, do you not?
Okay, yeah.
So like, and they're not experiencing muscle cramps. So like, meaning the cause is coming from like another influence, such as like the neuromuscular theory.
All right, Shane, I'm gonna teach you about neuromuscular theory. Muscles contract at a shorter length, creates two problems. In your muscles, there's an organ called the muscle spindle, which causes an excitatory reflex arc that causes your spinal cord to send out to cause an excitation reaction to your neuromuscular junction, causing your muscle to react. In your muscle tendon, there's an organ called the Golgi tendon organ, which inhibits that excitation reaction arc. So when you exercise your muscle at a shorter length, it inhibits the Golgi tendon organ from functioning. So there is no inhibition towards that reflex arc, which causes uncontrollable muscle spasm. So this whole idea, accompanied with the CNS, the central nervous system drive that we already talked about, how when you're fatigued, you're sending more signals towards your muscles to contract, creates an uncontrollable reflex arc, which, when specifically located in a calf, like a working muscle, causes an uncontrollable contraction, which we call an exercise-associated muscle cramp. This is supported by evidence that whenever you get that cramp, just like your old trainers would say, and any sort of historical trainer would say, when you get a cramp, pass a stretch. That what that passive stretch does, it puts tension through that muscle, activating that Golgi tendon organ in your tendon, which inhibits that reflex arc, which will cause your muscle to relax.
Sounds awesome. What can we do to help me win this gold medal?
So based on the theory we just explained, we can work on your biomechanical training to maintain your stride length at 2-hour mark when you experience those muscle cramps. Also, with this new compression suit we gave you, it'll focus on maintaining the muscle tension, which will help you out a lot.
Right.
But at the end of the day, these are preventative methods, as there is no one fix, as it has not been determined, as each case is very subjective.
Right on.
Don't worry, you're gonna win it.
Let's get to work.
All right, let's do it.
Let's go, Shane.
Yeah!
Hey, I'll fix you.
Hey, come on, now.
Yeah.
Thank you.
now take you to the men's 50-kilometer walk, where Shane C. Jones is leading the pack in the final sprint.